there, people, and welcome to yet another edition of the Doom P-Wad playthrough. I'm your host, Deathstalker, and today we shall be checking out a level known as LONGMTCH. One thing you should know is that Elder Scrolls Arena will be coming very shortly. I'm not exactly sure when I'm going to bother with doing it, but I believe it will be sometime this weekend. I have no rush, but at the same time, I also feel like kind of getting it done soon, so it will be happening eventually. Just know my usual method. I usually just randomly do it. So yeah, don't ever expect or follow any of my plans whatsoever, because they're probably going to all go to moot. I'm very, very unstable. Anyway, on to LONGMTCH, which I'm assuming is supposed to mean long match. It makes sense. It's by Shane Boyer, with help from K. Desrochers, T. Furst. Whatever on earth that is for a name. Yeah, it sounds like some weird rappers or something. It's a very weird name. This is 4/21/94. You see that in the date field, but that's beside the point. Let's see here. This level has been refined over the course of a couple of weeks through heavy playtesting. Hopefully an optimum blend of enemies, ammo, health, and tricks, as well as physical design, has been achieved. Please email any comments to above address. So yeah, this one has been tested a lot. So I'm expecting very good things here. A deathmatch, although single player is supported on one level of play, level. So yeah, another deathmatch level with some single player added on. Mid-sized so that players run into each other often enough, but all areas have multiple connections to other areas so there are no traps. Three big rooms, nicknamed the prison, the skull room, and the arena. These rooms have various windows, teleports, and interconnected passageways between them. Plenty of health, ammo, and armor to go around. Designed as a long-lasting deathmatch level, that would explain the name. The three weapons in the multiplayer game are the shotgun, rocket launcher, and one chainsaw. In the single-player game, a chain gun is added. Three secrets, including the happy room. What in God's name is the happy room? Anyway, long match replaces level 1 of episode 2. Alright. Single player is designed to be moderately hard, but shouldn't be impossible for Doom veterans. So it'll probably be very easy for us to complete, knowing how that usually works. The only skill level that has single player item placements is level 4, ultraviolence. So basically as usual for us. Alright, multiplayer increases the amount of health and ammo, and decreases the number of enemies. For those of you who like to play deathmatch with enemies, this level should allow respawn at the same time. Oh, so I guess it is possible to have deathmatch with enemies in Doom. Surprised I was never carried over to like Quake and later games. There are just enough enemies to annoy you! Multiplayer is set up for skill levels 1, 2, and 3. So depending on how much damage you want to take, choose accordingly. The item placement is the same between the three levels. To play two-player with respawn on skill 1, type blah 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 blah. Okay, so we also have two problems. These are known problems, by the way. First, there is a point when going from one sector into a door sector where the screen will momentarily turn black with speckles. Okay? I've run the latest BSP node generator on this WAD file with no change. I've seen this effect in other WADs, but don't know what to do to fix it. It doesn't affect gameplay, though. And this probably was like a limitation of the original Doom engine. The original Doom engine had a lot of weird anomalies. So, yeah, this is probably fits the GZ Doom. So, secondly, while in the happy room, believe me, you'll know what room I'm talking about when you see it, is transparent in the sense that you can shoot rockets or plasma through it. I set the line depths to impassable, but without success. Don't know why this happens. Still really doesn't affect gameplay all that much. okay? And please email me any comments you have, as I would like to be receptive to modifying this level or building a new one if people like this one. One interesting thing I have to ask, to you people. What would happen if we ended up deciding to email one of these people for one of these levels that happened 22 years ago? Yeah, all of a sudden, there's suddenly a comment in your email box or something for a level to be 22 years ago. You made this level! It's not working! Why isn't it working? Fix the level! Why isn't it working yet? Have you built the next level? I want another level from you! Where have you been? Yeah. That would be a very interesting message to get for a level you made 22 years ago. You probably totally moved off Doom and probably don't even remember the fact that you made a level. yeah, that's actually probably the case. A lot of these people, they probably don't even remember they made levels. Who knows if they're even playing video games anymore? Nevertheless, Doom. Yeah. So, with all that in mind, let's actually get started with Doom, because we have an obsession with shooting things. So, yeah, let's go! Kill! Die! Death! Despair! Torment! What in God's name am I getting myself into? I'm getting myself into Doom! Also, this is the first one I'm playing with the new version of OBS, which really doesn't change much of anything for you guys. Which is kind of why I didn't really bother mentioning it up until now, and I really am not sure why I mentioned it, besides the fact that I kind of mentioned the previous one, so I thought it'd kind of be nice to say I did it again. Though, in case anything ends up not working this time around. But yeah, as far as I know, nothing really should be changed, and yeah, the only real differences are stuff that really doesn't affect you, such as the ability to stream and record at the same time now, so probably it'll be all synced together. And various minor things like that. Anyway, what do we have in store for us? We got Doom! Well, who would have guessed by loading up Doom I would get a Doom game? Well, this is surprising. What next? Okay, three secrets. Thank goodness this guy was actually correct on the number of secrets that's in the level. How amazing, a readme that actually was right. Okay, we got 68 enemies. We got three secrets, we got a bunch of enemies, and I think I said all that, but let's get gun ammo, because that's important. The ability to shoot things is top priority. Okay, we got lots of doorways around here. Look at that, look at all the doorways. Hi there. I heard a door open. It's a trap! I don't know who opened this. But it was a trap! I had to kill you! It was a trap! Stop trying to do more traps! I already knew it was a trap! It's gonna just make Admiral Akbar go insane, isn't he? Because every time Akbar has to keep saying, it's a trap! Lost soul, run this way! I'll be back! Run! Things are trying to kill me everywhere I go! Help! I'm a maniac with a shotgun who doesn't know how to aim! Please, somebody help me! Where am I going? Where in God's name am I going? Ooh, I see a platform down there. Ready for mouse look. Okay, where in God's name am I going again? I think I've accomplished absolutely nothing. There's a pit down there. There's a pit at the bottom of the sea. Right, check down here. Yay, I got stuff! This reminds me of like a secret in Quake. Let's jump down to the second one. Yay! More goodies! Me likey, me likey. What's this button do? This button does nothing. Game. I see, you punch it. So what's exactly lowering? We're hearing stuff lower and raise and do all this craziness. Ow! You! Bloody! I see. You press this. It lowers this. And now it's like this raises. Come back! Come back! I want to shoot you! Hey! Work with me! And stop trying to ambush me. Let's make it very difficult to live. Okay, we got guys in cages to shoot at. That's always convenient to get rid of. Everyone needs being eliminated. We'll make it so that way I don't have to run around like a maniac. Yeah, look at that. I just hit a barrel. Amazing pro MLG shot, yeah. Yeah, I hit another barrel. I'm doing good at essentially hitting barrels. That seems to be my strong suit. My weak suit is the fact that I have no idea what I'm doing. And there's barons of hell throwing at me. Like, three of them. I could use a rocket launcher game. You said there was something about a rocket launcher? So I'm gonna leave these guys. And figure out where in God's name am I going. Oh, look! An imp! Imp! And, away I can't go. Find this fascinating. Where in God's name am I? Oh my God, it's a red door! Where am I? I just feel like I'm getting more and more lost. The one thing I've yet to be able to do is actually figure out where in God's name am I going. Ow! Well, that was a terrible idea on my part! Let's run this way. It seems appropriate. Ooh! I seem to have lowered an elevator. Hooray! My life is complete. I have found an elevator. So I wait for this to raise. And this leads back up here. Aha! Look at this. We've linked things together. At least somewhat. Now I have a general idea where I'm going. Let's have this mystery way over here. Let's come this way and kill stuff. Die! You, on the other side is giant pit. You will die! Sure, let's go this way. This is good. These look like elevators. And, there's guys that shoot at me. Did you just, like, die? I'm trying to get around here and live and all. Okay, we've made it to another platform. I'm not really sure why we're going down here. Well, all this is accomplishing. I found the blue key! Yay! My prayers have been answered. I have found the blue key. And I can just figure out where in God's name am I going. Ooh! I seem to have found the way back up. Now I'm hearing, like, doors open and closing all around me. Sure. Did anyone ever say there was too many ways to go and I'm totally lost? Yeah, I'm a bit lost right now. I'm kind of, like, just wandering around aimlessly and hoping for the best. Ooh, I found the secret. Or, at least a way to stuff. I want that barrel. Or artifacts. You always love them, because they're blurry. And that's good for some reason. Okay, what's this way? I am, by the way, people, totally lost. I have no clue where I am going at this point. Seriously. I think I've just managed to go around a giant circle. Oh, go me. I've accomplished absolutely, positively nothing. Yeah. Let's go with whatever this is. Okay, there's a pit of slime here, but there's also stuff over there. Let's run across this pit and see what happens. The rewards? Reward me, game! I managed to make you across a dangerous pit with my life intact! Okay, fine. I'll go down to the dangerous pit of slime. Because I want these little health packs, too. Ooh! Hi there! Okay, I'm not really sure why I did that, but sure, this way! Run for my life! There's things trying to kill me and I need a rocket launcher! You're not a rocket launcher! I seem to have opened the door. I don't know what I'm doing or where I'm going, I'm just kind of wondering if I'm able to shoot things. Hopefully this accomplishes stuff. Ooh, look, I found the blue artifact I've been looking for. And, this looks like the exit switch. Oh, goody. I found the exit switch. Good news! That means that now I can try and figure out exactly how to get around and get stuff. We still have a bunch of stuff to get. Including, well, where's the rocket launcher that he promised? Or the chain gun. Or all the other guns, actually. That's kind of an important fact. Where are all the guns? Okay, first thing first, there's a chain gun up there. I'm assuming I have to like drop onto this platform or something and kind of like run across. Exactly. Carefully. And we get the red key card. And then we get more careful and we can get this blur artifact. And over here! Yay! Look as I gather all this random junk. To slowly but surely take everything out that ever lived. Hooray! I don't know what I'm doing. Please help me. boy. Sure, let's go this way. This is a way. It's a route. It has things. You know what would be awesome? A rocket launcher. So, yeah, now what? That's kind of part of the problem here. If you look at the map, look at that, there's like a greenish area here. There's something over here. With enemies or so. I wanna get that way. That way has stuff. And I like stuff. Oh no, I wanna go that way. So hug this wall. Something around here. I see. How does this work in there? Game, you're gonna not make it easy for me. Why don't you make it easy for me? If you were a true friend, you'd make it easy. Because I'm trying to figure out where in God's name am I supposed to be going again. Okay, I want to go over that way. I'm not sure how I'm supposed to get over there. But, sure. We'll go with that. We'll go with the fact that matter that there is a way that I am supposed to go. And that way is down the slime-filled corridor. Wait, where is this? When was this a thing? The little tiny armor bonus? I like little tiny armor bonuses. Because that means I don't have to worry about them. Kind of important to know about. Okay, down here. And this leads to the pit, which leads somewhere. Not sure what I accomplished by being up there, besides getting hit a lot. Why do I get the feeling there's like something in these long corridors? And if I spam every one of these walls, eventually I'll get something? Spam walls! Always the answer! And now we present to you the Humping Wall Symphony! Doom Guy likes humping walls, and so will you! Next episode of the Humping Wall Symphony, with PG-13, with suggestive imagery. Yeah, you kinda get that way with humping walls. And, I'm totally lost in finding that rocket launcher. There's a rocket launcher and I want it. I want the rocket launcher. It's kind of important, but I need a rocket launcher. Lack of rocket launchers is going to drive me insane. Not totally the same, only partly the same, but enough insane that it will impair my ability to be the person I want to be in life. So we shall just chain gun these guys to death, I guess. We do have a rocket launcher. Not like we don't have the ammo, so why not? And after all, if we get rid of these guys, it might be easier to figure out where the enemies are coming from. And then we will have giant barons of hell guarding everything in the middle of this corridor. Howie. Okay, good news. We now have access to wander around aimlessly in this empty area. I hear lots of things that are angry at me. I assume there's like something up here. Stupid question of the day, but how do I get up from there? I probably about Doom is affected by that. Ooh, I found something! I have found something, people! Ooh. Treasure! I seem to be on a path to finding stuff. So yeah, all these lower. Fascinating. I found the rocket launcher! Now I get the bloody rocket launcher game! Of course. It was a stupid... I can't get on that one. I can't get on that one. But we have a way up there. And the answer is somehow involving this wall. If there's like a window to get out or something. But how? How, game? How? I'm trying to find the answer! Let me get a berserk pet. That way we can punch things better. And that way if we find the answer... I have found the answer! And it seems to be in a form of a bunch of demons. Now, what was the point of all that? Well, beyond to get a bunch of kills out of the way. And to shut everyone up. Go me! I made it! Listen here, this locks up. Do not run in here. This is bad. So, what's the point of this? If this is the area in which things come out of, and the whole point of this was to open an area, then why when I get in here is there not a way out or something? Yeah, this is it. This is all we got. This is... Wow. It's just like totally pointless. Why even go in there? Ooh! Secret! Yay! I found the other secret! I still don't know where the happy thing is. And I'm assuming that's like the final secret. Is where the happy thing is. The question is, where's happy thing? Okay, if we can find our way to the area with the slime. While I have this invulnerability on. Because I want to check around there. And I don't want to do it when I have the ability to die. Mm-hmm. Ta-da! Now I've checked y'all. I know for a fact it is not there. Or at least not without chainsawing or something. Which could always be a possibility, so yeah. But, we found the second secret. We got two. And, yeah. There's still a wall we're missing over here. Let's get that wall, so that way we feel a little bit better. I'm self-conscious about the lack of walls. If I was a secret, which I'm not, I would be hidden somewhere in this map! Which it probably is. And this is what my wisdom has told me in my years of playing Doomwads. Not anyone could just think of this! Nope, sorry, no! This takes a really experienced Doom player, one that has been playing for a very long time and is seeing everything that there is to see. I mean, now I'm looking for a happy area. Has anyone seen a happy area? I'm looking for an area that makes you happy. Or something like that. I really don't know. But let's start punching walls. That always makes me happy. So, yeah. How are you guys all doing over there? You're doing well, I'm doing well, I'm trying to punch walls! And, I seem to have found a barrel. That's a big part of the problem. There are barrels everywhere. Doom guy has found some stuff. Doom guy's attempt at finding stuff has led him to other stuff. This is a constant problem for Doom guy, as stuff is not exactly ideal when you're trying to wander around aimlessly in the level. Yeah! Blow up a barrel! Okay, I don't know what I've accomplished at all. I found the random barrel and blew it up. Does that count as doing something productive in my life? I was always yelled at, I'm told to do something productive in my life. Hopefully that was good enough. Okay, I landed in a random platform. Sure! Let's go with that. Where in God's name am I? Let's go this way. Nothing bad could go wrong but this way! Sure, I have no idea where in God's name am I going. I want to go to the happy area. I want to go to the happy room! I want to be happy! Why can't I be happy?! See? This is a problem with life! I can't be happy! Oh my god! What? How did I get here? How did I even get in here? I don't know what I just did. I somehow blundered upon a random teleporter and kind of wandered in here. Go me? Yeah, go me, I guess. Sure, let's grab some stuff. I think this is the happy area. Because it has a lot of random stuff in it. Die. Die. Sure, who else? Oh my god! What the? What the? Look at that! What the? Really? Oh my god, we have a random smiley face. Oh, that's just brilliant. That right there makes my day. That is what we played for, people. This is what everything has come up to. This was the importance of the entire Doom level. We also got all the weapons. Ammo and all that, I mean. But we have a kind of big problem. Specifically, well... Die! We still have two enemies that are missing in the map. I heard somebody. Some guy's thinking he's a wise guy. Some guy wants to not make me happy. So, yeah. Demons. Better learn to make your guy happy, or else he'll be gonna punch you, pop you in the head, Oh yeah, this doesn't sound messed up at all. Okay, where in God's name am I? And where is the guy that's... This way. I seem to have found what I was looking for! Die! Yay! I have achieved nothing! Okay, we've achieved a lot. We've gotten everything done. Time to figure out my way out of this place. I like to punch things, but we must get out of here, because we have more epic quests to complete, such as... Where else in God's name am I going? But yeah! Happy area! Okay, let's see here. Where in God's name is the exit? This way, up here, around here, down here, and sure enough, here's the exit door. Look at that. Beautiful exit door. With cylinders, for some reason. I don't know why it makes random noises like that at times. Cylinders. Symbols! Symbols! What am I saying? And I'm talking random shapes. Yeah, shapes! Shapes! They are roundish! Yeah! They have lines! So anyway. That level wasn't terrible by any means, but it also wasn't that interesting. I don't know if I can define why or why not. It just feels like one of those random 1994 ones that just didn't have anything to draw me in. And generally just felt like a bunch of interconnected areas that didn't have any consensual theme or something. Consensual. What am I with weird terms today? But yeah, it didn't have any consistent themes. Everything looked totally different from each other. Some rooms were hellish looking. Other rooms were kind of like base looking. And there really was no sense of order in the place. Some nice use of like vertical stairs and all that. But then we had areas where you could get trapped inside the level. And generally speaking, a lot of inconvenient things like... that second secret was a pain in the butt and whatnot to find. We only kind of found it because one convenient thing about GZ Doom is some areas are shown as being thinner on the map or so as to show like their doors or something because they have like thinner surfaces than normal. So yeah, that's kind of a way you can sometimes figure out where a secret is. I don't know if that was in the original game. I believe it would be. Like I said, I can't imagine GZ Doom in the original game changing its programming. Please somebody correct me if I'm wrong. I don't want to find out I'm actually exploiting something for this longer period of a time. But I believe it works the same mechanics and same way. It's just a much easier interface for me to read. And because of that, I'm able to therefore use it and figure out kind of where I'm going. And generally get kind of an idea where some secrets might be. And as you see, it depends on the level if we actually find something with it or not. And luckily, sometimes it'll happen at a level like this where the walls were so cruel or whatnot. I mean, look at it. The second one was inside a pillar area that you wouldn't have otherwise really seen. The first secret, what was the first secret? I completely forget. That was actually like Quake or something like that. And yeah, that secret wasn't at all bad. That was normal ideas or whatnot, how you do a secret. And the third one was just kind of random teleporter or something in an area that you just wouldn't normally look, I guess. But it does make sense since it's a secretive area, so it's very acceptable. But that middle one, I'm not too sure about because I don't think there's anything that clued you in. Unless the map and the thinness of walls. So I'm hoping thinness of walls is actually a valid thing. So that way I can defend some of these. Because if not, then we have to really start bashing a lot more levels because of the fact it mattered that, you know, they don't have thin walls or whatnot on the other map, so that's not even a clue. So if anything, you'd be going even more insane trying to figure out where these blaze secrets are because your map doesn't tell you. I did like the happy area or whatnot. That was a very interesting idea. overall, though, it was just really, like... randomness, a bunch of empty corridors, some areas where you could fight some barons. And like I said, the biggest problem is that it's a level designed for deathmatch, so it's a bunch of interconnected areas that really just come off as not really feeling like anything special or standoffish. Like I said, that's generally how like a deathmatch level is kind of made. I don't know why this is. I guess because of the fact of the matter of just how Deathmatch is designed in general. But I don't usually find Deathmatch maps that interesting to look at, because usually they tend to just be a bunch of interconnected areas that are just kind of like a mess to look at and whatnot. Because generally speaking, Deathmatch maps aren't made to be really experiences that you look at. Generally speaking, they're made for efficiency and just moving through the level to kill things as fast as possible. So, yeah, I could see why they kind of started with, like, Quake not having monsters in them and whatnot, because there's a big difference. In a single-player level, you usually focus on progression, while in a multiplayer level, you want as many interconnected ways as possible. If you have a bunch of interconnected ways in single-player, it gets too quick. You cannot, you'll complete the level in 2 seconds. It's kind of that difficulty between non-linearity and actually making a level that isn't just you can complete it by walking around a certain way and make it ridiculously easy, avoid all challenges and whatnot. And that's kind of part of the problem with, like, Deathmatch or so. I mean, these levels do have, like, key cards. They have certain things that prohibit them. But overall, they just feel like a bunch of sparse corridors that just really get boring. Though, I could even say that for the original game. So, I guess if you're a fan of the original game, you might like some of these. But in my opinion, they just feel hollow, they feel empty, and they feel disinteresting. They just end up feeling like sprawling messes that really don't have any appeal to them. So anyway, with all that in mind, thank you very much all for watching. I shall see you all next time.